go? It's only me. Why didn't you answer when I knocked before?
You frightened me, Paul. What are you doing here?
Well, I only came to walk home with you. Don't you realize the streets of Paris aren't safe after dark with Bluebeard still at large?
Damn it! The Bluebeard didn't get you. Where were you? What are you trying to do? Drive me to my grave? Constance, it's already as dark as pitch. Lucille, will you hurry? Do you want us to leave and let you walk home alone?
Coming, Babette.
But you needn't have waited for me. Do you hear her? As if she wouldn't be scared to death to walk alone on the streets these nights. Why do you suppose it is the police haven't caught him? Whom? Whom? Why, Bluebeard, of course. Who else is all Paris terrified of?
Oh, Bluebeard. I'd forgotten.
Come on, I want to get home. Now let's stay close together for safety. Puppeteer. Hello. Constance seems afraid of her own shadow. When are you going to give a show in the park again?
Perhaps quite soon.
These are my friends, Constance and Lucille. I forget your name.
Gaston Morrell.
I always think of you just as the puppeteer. You've seen his puppet shows in the park, of course.
No, I've missed that.
You mean you've missed his wonderful puppet operas? Oh, they're great fun.
I should like to see one sometime.
I should like you to. I haven't been showing my puppets much of late. It's difficult to get a crowd these evenings because of the Bluebeard scare. But if you say you'll come, I'll give one tomorrow night.
Tomorrow night? What do you say?
Well, I...
Of course you'll come. He's afraid of Bluebeard.
Aren't you?
What would Bluebeard want with me?
I should think he might find you irresistible, mademoiselle.
You'll give the puppet show tomorrow night, then?
At the same place.
We'll be there. Won't we, Lucille?
Yes. Tomorrow night.
If your kiss is dear one, say to love, go on, be gone. Without a wedding ring, without a wedding ring.
Marguerite, having been convinced that Faust deserted her, and in a fit of despair, having killed her child, finally found the courage to give herself up. She was tried and sentenced to prison, where Faust, with the aid of Mephistopheles, finds her.
Ah, where's the voice of my beloved? My lonely heart is fast to his core.
Marguerite!
Come to my heart.
Rain
Tyranny. You take over and help this old demonstrate the puppets to whoever comes back. I'm going to take up the collection tonight. Show?
Very much.
Thank you. I created the puppets myself.
Did you make the costumes?
Well, I designed them. Why?
Lucille's a modiste, so it's natural. She's interested in clothes.
Modiste? Do you think you can make some new costumes for me?
Oh, well, I...
Come backstage. Let me show you the costumes.
If that was a woman, you wouldn't need no string to make her talk.
How do you make the eyes move?
Oh, the eyes. Oh, that's very simple. You see these two strings here.
You like my little people, huh?
Very much. They seem quite real to me.
They're all likenesses of people I've known.
Mephistopheles, too?
Yes, the evil one, too. One of the things, he's also my business manager.
And Marguerite. Is she a friend of yours?
She was.
What?
Yes, unfortunately, she met a tragic ending.
It must have been very beautiful.
They say you'll show me how the puppets work.
Let's get out of here until these people leave. They'll be asking endless questions. I can't talk with all the people around.
I should think in your business you like crowds.
As a puppeteer, you mean? As a matter of fact, I prefer creating puppets to performing them.
You make them act so well. There's something in your voice that made me feel you'd suffered.
You're very discerning.
It's your Marguerite. The memory of that tragedy, isn't it?
Partly.
And you're keeping the tragedy alive deliberately, aren't you?
Why,
if you wanted to forget it, you could create a new puppet. One that would remind you of someone else. Someone who might make you happy. Is it much trouble to create a puppet?
It takes time. First, I make a sketch.
A painting? Do you paint, too?
Enough to get the effect. You know you have very lovely eyes. Truthful eyes. Would you let me make a puppet in your image?
Would you like to?
Very much. Let's see.
Are you trying to decide how you'll paint me?
No. I'm not going to paint you.
Lucille!
You better go with him. You better stay close to
him. But your Marguerite costume. Don't you want me to make it for you?
As you please. Where's Renee?
Oh, looking for you.
Oh. Was she difficult?
Well, the way she always is when you avoid her.
She comes back, tell her I'm looking for her.
Which you won't be.
Of course not. Good night, Lucille.
Good night. You picked up a little something?
What? Oh, you mean some money?
For the musicians, you know.
For the musicians, of course.
Oh, my word of honor.
Thank you.
friends who stay at the puppet show.
We watch you flirt with that girl. Who is she?
I don't know. Just a girl.
Another, I suppose, to take my job for a few days. A few weeks. And you think you'll come back to me again?
I think you'd better go now, Renee.
Oh, no, not this time.
Renee?
I won't stand for it.
I warn you. You'll regret it.
Regret it? Gaston, I've regretted it from the start. From the first day I met you.
I didn't ask you to fall in love with me.
No. Then why did you keep telling me you needed me? That I was necessary to your success? What was I to think?
What did you think, Renee?
Gaston, these girls. I've known they didn't mean anything to you, really. Because you always came back to me. Gaston, what's happened to them?
You think?
This is the gentleman, Inspector Lefevre, Gaston Morrell.
Monsieur Morrell, you saw the body.
It is Renee, all right.
Renee?
Renee Clermont. She's been singing for me in my puppet show for almost a year now.
Oh, I see. Sorry, these are our routine questions. Morrell, how did you know the girl was missing?
She was to have rehearsed with me this morning. When she didn't show up, I went to her room. When there was no answer, I got the concierge to let me in. Her bed had not been slept in. I called again a little while ago. She had not turned up. The concierge, it was, told me the police found another girl in the Seine this morning. Another victim of Bluebeard, so I got worried.
Have you any idea who had a motive to kill her?
I can't think of anyone. She was always so kind.
When did you see her last?
At the puppet show.
She left before I did. You can prove that, of course.
Of course.
You didn't notice if she left with anyone?
No, I didn't. It's always quite crowded backstage after the performance. People come back to see how we pull the strings. Renee slipped away before I knew she was gone.
You didn't by chance notice anyone in the crowd that struck you as unusual?
I'm sorry, I can't give you any information that might help you.
We are grateful for your identification, and we will call on you if there's any further way you can help us. Good evening.
Thank you. Good evening.
Renard?
Yes?
Send for Francine Etienne. Rush her back to Paris at once.
But Inspector...
At once.
Good evening. You have come to tell me when we will give Faust again?
Now, how can we give Faust again until we find a new Marguerite?
Oh, Mademoiselle Renee is not with us anymore. What a pity. She had a good voice. You have somebody else in mind for Marguerite?
No.
I'm thinking of giving a new puppet show.
Show?
Yes, something on the order of a ballet with a lot of new costumes.
Oh. What is her name?
Lucille Etienne.
Where do I find this one?
Madame Blanche, Maudit's shop.
When do you want her to sit for you?
I'm not going to paint this one.
No?
Definitely not. I merely want her to make some costumes for me.
That's a new one.
It's a fact. Nothing more. Just to make some costumes for my puppets.
At your studio?
I don't know where she'll make them. I don't even know if she will make them. That's what I want you to find out.
When?
As soon as possible. Oh, and a soldat.
Huh?
There are two girls, friends of hers. I can trust you to exclude them.
My word of honor.
What do you mean breaking in here? We don't admit beggars.
I did not come here professionally. That is, not from a standpoint of my profession. I came here on a very confidential mission to see Mademoiselle Lucille.
I'm Lucille. Did you want to see me?
Oh, yes. Privately. A certain gentleman has requested me to ask if you would do him a great favor.
Who?
Gaston Morrell, the puppeteer.
Oh, the puppeteer?
Yes. He wanted to know if you would make some costumes for his new puppets.
Why, yes, I'd be delighted to. When?
Now.
Where is he?
At his studio.
Why, I'll go right along with you.
Yes. He has so many ideas. One never knows what he will turn up with next. I always hope one day he will make a stouncer after me.
Hi, see you.
I will run along.
Won't you come in?
So this is where you work.
It is.
The puppet. Did you make them?
Yeah.
You don't seem very glad to see me.
I'm delighted. These are the costumes. Do you think you can make them?
They're quite good. Did you create them?
Scarcely. They're period.
Oh. Why so many?
I'm thinking of devoting more time to my puppets. Up till now, they've been merely a toy, sideline.
To your painting?
Yes. I'm giving up my painting.
Why?
I have my reasons.
Well, of course. About the costumes, would you like me to make one for your approval?
Take your choice.
This. Plain to be seen a woman's cares lacking here.
Is the place that dirty?
Oh, like any bachelor quarter.
Give me that.
It's torn.
I meant to throw it away.
It's just lovely material.
It was my favorite.
It needs only a stitch or two.
Throw it away.
Oh, it'd be a crime to. A few seconds will put it right. Why'd you decide not to paint me? In the park after the show, you better make a puppet after me. You seem really interested. Something happened. What?
I can't tell you that.
Did I do something or say something?
No.
Were you disappointed after seeing me more closely?
On the contrary.
Then what?
You asked too many questions.
Oh, you don't like being asked questions?
No.
Got something to hide?
Yes.
Good. And suppose I promise not to ask any more questions.
You're very charming. Quite unlike any person I've painted before. I wonder.
Here we are. All fixed. Now you can use it again.
Police have found the body of the last girl.
Well?
Why must you continue to throw them into the Seine for the police to find?
You know why.
That's the most frightening obsession of yours, Gaston. It has put me to great expense smuggling your paintings out to France to be disposed of.
You must make enough out of the transaction to be always after me for another canvas. Is that what you're here for now, before you've disposed of the last one?
As a matter of fact, I've sold the last one.
Already?
Yes. The Duke of Cadignan was in my shop the other day, looking for something unusual.
The Duke of Cadignan? Don't tell me you've sold it to him.
Oh, he didn't give me any fancy price, such as he's noted for. A mere 5,000 francs.
Fool, the Duke of Cadignan always exhibits his collections. What if someone should recognize the girl?
The people who attend the Duke's exhibits are not likely to know such an obscure girl.
But his exhibits are public. Anybody can get in. You'd better persuade him not to show that picture.
That might arouse his suspicions.
Buy it back from him. You said he gave you only 5,000.
I don't think he would part with it.
The girl in that painting was one of Bluebeard's victims.
Bluebeard?
The fourth, to be exact.
Are you sure?
Positive.
Oh, this is most distressing.
One of our men on guard here at your exhibit noted his resemblance and called my attention to it. I investigated, and there can be no doubt it's the same girl.
Most unfortunate.
Most fortunate for us that you happened to buy the picture. As I'm sure that we can count on your cooperation.
Naturally, I'll do anything in my power, Inspector.
Thank you. What do you know about the painter?
Nothing. I bought the canvas largely on the recommendation of the art dealer. Although, of course, I recognized its great merit.
Who was the art dealer?
Jean Lamarte. You know him?
Only by reputation. Lamarte. What did he tell you about the painter?
As a matter of fact, he was evasive on that point. But he did intimate the painter was someone of reputation who executed this canvas under the pseudonym of Albert Garon.
Lamarte. I think I'll pay him a visit.
Don't seem to recall such a canvas. Of course, the Duke buys many pictures, and not all from me, unfortunately.
But this one, he recalls distinctly having bought here. It was painted by one Albert Garon.
Albert Garon? I don't recall his name.
Strange, because he informed me he paid 30,000 francs for it. Because you had told him that someday this painter would be quite famous.
I might have seen great talent in painting. I've frequently backed my own judgment successfully.
Have you, by any chance, any other paintings by this Bergeron?
I'm sorry to say I haven't. But I have a canvas by another very promising young man, if you are interested.
Yes, I might be.
This way, please.
Thank you.
And this one is very reasonable.
Yes. Yes, it's rather good. But not as striking as the Goron. You think you could locate this Goron for me? He might have something else I would like. You must have a record of that painting.
Come to think of it, I do recall that canvas now. A plain dark girl against a bizarre background. An old man brought it in to me one day.
Oh, the painter himself?
No, some old man I've never seen before. He said he needed money.
You happen to know his name?
I paid cash. His name didn't interest me.
Do you happen to know from whom he got the painting?
No. He merely mentioned it had been in the family a long time. But why all this interest in Albert Garon, may I ask?
Well, I'm interested in his work. Are you sure you couldn't contact him for me?
I wouldn't have the vaguest idea how to locate him.
Well, I'm sorry, Monsieur Lamarte. I'm afraid we can't do any business at the moment.
If I knew where to reach you, gentlemen.
Oh, I might drop in some other time.
Thank you.
Jean?
Darling, when'd you get back?
I'm straight off the train. Oh, what a filthy trip. I had to get bathed right away, even before I could report to the office.
You mean you have to go to the office tonight?
Oh, yes. From the telegram I received, you'd think the whole of Paris was holding his breath until I got back.
Was he with you?
He?
Who?
You know whom I mean. You never told me his name.
Oh, Jacques. No, he was not with me. It was Jacques who sent the telegram.
Francine, it's outrageous. You're never home anymore. That position of yours...
Wait a minute. Remember our agreement? I'm not to interfere in your affairs, and you're not to in mine. For me, you'll simply have to wait.
Good evening. I brought one of my little people for her to use as a model.
Who is it, Lucille?
It's one of my customers.
Then why are you making clothes for men?
For puppets. The puppeteer.
Well, have him come in. I'll stay out of sight.
It's my little sister, Francine. I'm sorry she isn't presentable. I'd like you to meet her.
Tell him to come in and wait. I won't be long.
Won't you come in?
What's the matter? Was he afraid to...
Good evening, Francine. This is Gaston Morrell.
How do you do?
Usually better than this. I'll be out in a minute.
I really can't stay. I thought if you had one of the puppets for fittings, that they're... They're all pretty much the same size.
Oh, then you want me to go right ahead and make the clothes?
Certainly.
I'd be glad to.
Then, if you'll excuse me. I'm very glad to have met you, mademoiselle.
Happy to have met you.
Good night.
Good night.
Just a customer, eh?
Yes, just a customer.
Well, that's the first time I've heard them called puppet.
Oh, they just came with the puppet.
Oh, sure. To keep it from breaking. Well, he's not bad looking. The one who pulls the strings, I mean.
Oh, Francine. I can't tell you how glad I am. Well, of course, we all are to have you back.
Thank you, Inspector. Oh, may I present my sister?
Your sister? But you never told me you had such charming sister.
I'm no fool. How do you do?
I'm very happy to know you. Really, Francine has told me a great deal about you. Gentlemen, that will be all for the present. Well, now you must tell me about your success. Won't you sit down? And you? Well, now we can talk. Tell me all about yourself.
I thought you called me back here on business. About Bluebeard.
Bluebeard. He's a thorn in my side. I seem to be getting nowhere.
What have you done so far?
Here's a complete dossier. I want you to read it when you find time. Up to recently, I had him classified as a painter. But we have questioned practically every art authority in Paris. Yes, Professor Voisin. And even Recamier down. And now we are questioning artist models. But no one seemed to know this man's technique.
Well, I don't quite follow you.
You see, I have the painting that the Duke of Cadino bought. However, it would be much quicker to show you. Would you come along, too?
You two go ahead. I'll stay here.
All right. Only down the hall. We'll be back in 2 minutes.
Smart.
Hélène Borot.
Hello, Mademoiselle Francine Jack.
Delighted.
How do you do? How are you, Renard?
Oh, thank you. I'm very well.
Commissaire de Champ.
Le Roy. You are an artist's model?
At the Beaux-Arts.
Will you please study that picture? Have you any idea who actually painted that picture?
No.
You will notice the distinctive style. In what would you say that distinction lies?
In the background.
Exactly. Have you ever known a painter who used that type of background?
No.
Next girl.
Mimi Robert.
And so it goes, Francine, with no one seeming to know this painter's work.
Perhaps if I were to question Lamarte.
No. He's too suspicious already. Lamarte is the dealer who sold Duke the painting. I suspect that he knows the painter, but I have no proof yet.
Would you mind questioning a few, Inspector? I've been at it for hours.
Certainly, Renaud, certainly. You understand, Mademoiselle, you're not here on trial for any offense.
Oh, that's good.
We are merely qualifying witnesses. You are an artist model?
But of course. What do you take me for?
Mademoiselle, that's beside the point.
Riot in the courtroom!
I've modeled for the greatest painters of France.
Oh, no doubt. But we are only interested in contemporary artists.
And the most famous sculptors, too. You know, of course, the Venus di Milo.
Oh, yes. An historic masterpiece. But surely you're not going to tell us you modeled for her.
Quiet!
I'm the exact duplication of her measurement.
But recently, have you been occupied as a model?
Well, not exactly as a model. You see, since I've retired,
well, myself,
I've been...
I don't think we need to go into that.
Just one question. Do you know who Albert Galland is?
Albert Galland? But of course!
Who is he?
Bluebeard!
Take a look at that picture. Have you any idea who that painter might be?
Well, when I modeled for money...
The question is, do you know who painted that?
No.
Next model.
Lorenzo Feroz.
Listen, I have an idea.
You got Carignan, right? You want a portrait of your daughter and ask me to help you find a satisfactory painter.
Being strangers here, we naturally look to the Duke, who is a relative, for recommendations regarding a number of things.
My trousseau chiefly.
The Duke is a man of excellent taste.
Yes. Among his paintings, I noticed one that particularly attracted me. The canvas of a young girl against a rather startling background. I was wondering if this painter is available.
What did the Duke to say of that painter?
Unfortunately, we had no opportunity of asking him.
You see, we only arrived in Paris last evening, just before the Duke left town.
Yes, and since we're sailing back to South America before he returns, we had the chance only for a few intimate matters, and I mentioned wanting a portrait.
What was his painter's name?
I couldn't make it out very well. Garon? Possibly. At any rate, whoever he is, his flesh tones are superb. It was that which decided me that this is the painter to capture my daughter's subtle beauty.
Please, Father.
Unfortunately, Monsieur Deschamps, I do not know the painter you have reference to.
But surely, Monsieur, for a commission, you could look him up. Rather a good commission.
I would know where to find him.
But for a commission of 75,000 francs, you could advertise?
Advertise. $150,000 might make an attractive figure.
Agreed.
But mind you, I don't promise I will have success.
Well, at least you can try. Oh, by the way, let me give you a little something on account.
That isn't necessary. But if I do find this painter, and he turns out to be someone of reputation, painting under a pseudonym, he may not wish to use that name.
Whatever name he paints under does not concern me, so long as he is the painter who did the canvas I liked so much.
It's well to have such matters understood.
But it will have to be painted soon. Don't forget, I want to take it with me to South America.
I'll do my best. If I have any good news for you, I'll get in touch with you at once. At the Duke's.
We will be most grateful to you, Monsieur Lamarte.
Thank you. If you paid me my rent, you could dictate which way I should enter my own property.
You've made plenty out of my paintings in the past.
I made a small profit in the past. You think I'm going to let you go on living here for nothing?
I'll pay you.
What? What do you make with your puppet show?
I'll manage.
Don't be ridiculous. But I'll make you a proposition. 25,000 francs, if you will do.
25,000?
I might even get you 30.
Oh, that would give me a magnificent puppet show.
A dozen of them.
What's the proposition?
A rich South American wants a portrait of his daughter.
Oh,
I thought so. No. I've told you, I'm through painting.
So you can be, for good, after just this one. Think of it, Gaston. 30,000 francs.
I am thinking of it. No, it's too risky. Besides, I've told you, I won't pay any more of your girls.
But this is different. This is a portrait, and this is safe. She's leaving almost at once for South America to be married, and she's taking the painting with her.
It's a trap.
Do you think I would run any further risk?
There's no risk. Why shouldn't I paint her at your studio?
My studio?
Yes. The workroom over your shop. That's all right to paint a portrait in.
Why? Yes. So it is.
I paint her there or I don't paint her.
All right. All right, Gaston. You paint her there.
So the shop will be completely surrounded with every possible escape route. But how are we to know that this Garon has actually showed up at Lamarte's?
We'll give you a signal. The sham can stand at the window and light his cigar. You notice that window at the back of the office.
Station someone that can watch the window and relay the signal.
But don't enter too soon. Give the painter a chance actually to start painting.
That's it. We must have something on the canvas as evidence. Perhaps, Francine, you could persuade the painter to demonstrate the background intensities.
I'll try, surely. The signal will mean only that the artist has arrived and started painting.
Yes. I'll leave the timing to you, Renard, but remember, you are also absolutely responsible.
He further stipulated that there should be absolutely no visitors. Not even you, sir. Rather than risk his outright refusal, I accept it.
Yes, but my daughter...
Oh, you needn't be concerned about me. And I'm sure Lamarte will not object if you wait here and smoke.
Not at all.
Well?
So, if you will be good enough to excuse it, I'll take the lady to our painting. Permitted to work unobserved. He finds it more satisfactory that way. The senorita is here. Are you ready?
Quite ready.
I hope you will be quite comfortable. If there is anything you want, you have only to call down the speaking tube.
Thank you.
The artist understands the need for haste is quite agreeable. Therefore, I won't take up any more time.
Pose me.
I must ask you to do that yourself. The effect will be more individual. Ready?
He started. So if you don't mind, we'll get on with our business arrangements.
I have brought the cash as you stipulated.
For the full amount?
150,000 francs.
Good. I'll write you a receipt.
Surely you must have done some pictures other than the one I saw at the Duke's. Haven't you?
Pardon?
I say I would love to see some other pictures you've done.
Thank you. Head higher, please.
Have you a match?
They frequently come in handy. I have some interesting curios back here, if you'd like to look at them. But I wouldn't like to tempt prying eyes.
I wore this simple dress thinking you might give me an interesting background. I like particularly the background you gave that girl in the Duke's picture. Do you think you could do one for me like that?
I could.
You have not lighted your cigar.
Eh? Well, I've been smoking a little too much lately, and besides, I got interested in this statue.
Good. Then you won't mind excusing me a moment while I go up and see how our painting is coming on?
By all means, go ahead.
Don't you think we better?
I'll tell you why.
But your shoulders, can't you straighten up? Not so square.
Well, I've asked you to pose me. I'm quite helpless about such things.
Surely it can't be so difficult for you to be yourself. What's the matter?
Lucille's puppeteer.
Lucille?
So you're Bluebeard.
Who said so?
Lamarte.
Lamarte told you. And you believe what Lamarte told you? How many others have you told that I painted the pictures you sold to the Duke?
No one. No one.
You're not telling me the truth. And you were trying to sneak out of here, leaving the blame for this to me as well.
No. No. I want it.
Time, didn't you? You were going to be gone from here when they got in.
Mm-hmm.
towards the river. Keep a sharp lookout.
Certainly isn't going to help us any. Where's Francine?
He took her out there.
Closer in capturing him than we were before, not even that close. Lamarte was the only one that we had to follow. Unless I can find out what happened to that cravat. But I've been all over town, making the rounds at the shops and nothing.
A cravat?
Yes, this one.
You say he used this?
Yes, as a garrote.
Then you think the owner of this cravat is the murderer?
Very likely. If not, he probably could take us to the murderer. Proceed. I don't know how to say this, but you know how I felt about Francine. She's your sister. If I only could make you believe, I would do everything I can. Now we have something in common, haven't we?
Yes.
Perhaps I should go in.
Please do.
Deepest sympathy.
Is that the cravat I mended for you?
This, very likely.
What happened to the stitches?
It may not be the same one. I have several alike.
Several?
Half a dozen, maybe, at home in my drawer.
May I ask where you got them?
In a little shop on a plaster glaze, I think. Why?
I just wondered. Such unusual material for a cravat.
Yes. Fragile. Would you be so kind?
Would you care to go in?
My interest is in the living. I called chiefly to offer my condolences.
Thank you.
Thank you.
come in?
Please do.
I mended for you.
All right. If you must know, I threw it away.
Oh, I wish I could believe you.
You've been through a lot this year. Sit down. Let me bring you something. Some cognac?
Nothing. Thank you. Where were you last night?
Right here. Working on my puppets.
Whole evening?
I did go out for a little while.
To paint someone?
Haven't I told you I don't want to paint anymore?
But that merely meant you wouldn't paint me. Why was that?
What good would Luther tell you? You don't believe anything I say to you.
Why wouldn't you?
As a matter of fact, I was becoming too fond of you.
Fond?
Yes. But it was more than fondness. I found myself falling in love with you. Really in love.
Why should I prevent you from painting me?
Lucille, I'm going to tell you something no other living person knows. Then maybe you'll understand how much I do love you. And why I don't want to paint you. I was a very ambitious youth, Lucille. And extremely sensitive. I almost starved to death as an art student. I didn't mind physical starvation. There was something in me. A burning ambition of striving to paint something really worthwhile. Something fine. I worked feverishly at the Beaux-Arts, never seeming to get anywhere. I painted every model who came there, but the canvases all turned out to be, one after another, just ordinary. And then, one night, as I was going home to my garret, I came across a girl. She collapsed. I didn't know what to do. My garret was close by. I carried her there. Took care of her as best I could. I had little money, barely enough for my paints. She needed nourishment or she would have died. Somehow I managed to get her the things she needed. Then one day, to pass the time, I began to paint Jeanette. That was her name. Jeanette LeBeau. There was something in her fever-tormented eyes that was almost spiritual. Something that reminded me of someone I'd seen. Then it came to me. The Maid of Orleans. I'd seen the tomb of the Maid of Orleans. And it inspired me. Then by chance, I sold the painting to Lamarte. Jeanette recovered after that, and then one day, without a word, she disappeared. And then one night, Lamarte turned up at my garret with a letter. Informed me that the Academy had awarded my picture, the Maid of Orleans, the prize. Would hang in the Louvre. And I was being recommended for the Legion of Honor. My work in the Louvre. I was almost insane with joy. Quite naturally, I wanted to share my happiness with the one who was chiefly responsible for it, Jeanette. I went looking for her, searching everywhere. At last, I traced her through the doctor I'd called in for her. He gave me her address. I went there. Outside her door, I heard laughter. But what laughter? Then, it was then I really saw her. She invited me in. but she wasn't the same as Renee. This was the real Jeanette. A low, coarse, loathsome creature. She offered me money. I suppose she'd probably pay me with money. Suddenly the sight of that Jeanette did something to me. Something indescribably infuriating. I thought that would stop her defiling the image I created of her. Stop her degrading my work. I thought that would be the end of what she could do to me, but it wasn't. Every time I painted again, I painted Jeanette. So I turned to making puppets because I could make them of wood. Because when they became Jeanette, I could take out my fury on them. I couldn't kill wood. There's no money in puppets. At least not enough for Lamarte. I owed Lamarte a lot of money. And only he knew that I'd kill Jeanette. So I had to paint for Lamarte. He wanted pictures of girls he could sell. But again, every girl I painted turned out to be Jeanette. I couldn't permit it. I couldn't stop myself. Every time I painted her, I had to kill her again. Finally, life seemed to mean nothing to me, not even my own. Then I saw you. In you, I knew I had found what I'd missed in my existence. What I'd thought I might find in Jeanette and didn't. I knew I saw a chance for fulfillment. I knew I couldn't live my life over again to deserve you. I knew I couldn't undo the wrongs I'd done. But I could prevent further ones. That's why I definitely quit painting once and for all. I decided there must be no more killings for your sake. That's why I couldn't paint you. Now do you understand?
Yes. Yes. Why, Francine?
Francine. I didn't want to kill her. I accepted that one last commission because it would mean independence. There wasn't to be a chance for a slip-up. That's why I was to paint her at Lamarte's studio, with him standing by. I didn't recognize the girl that came there as your sister until it was too late. All I realized suddenly was she was coming between us, you and me. Cutting me off from you. Making her one chance of happiness.
You think anything could justify her murder?
Anyone seeking to destroy our happiness is a menace. A menace that would have to be done away with. What are you going to do?
The only thing I can do.
You're not thinking of going to the police?
Why not?
You wouldn't do that.
Wouldn't I?
Lucille! You couldn't do that to me. Not you, Lucille. And even if you could, I wouldn't let you. I wouldn't let you turn against me, too. Oh, no, not you, Lucille. Not you.
Smash in the door. Quickly.
I followed you. I saw when you looked at that cravat that you had some idea.